إن الحمد لله، إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. ثم أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله جل وعلا، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة دلالة، وكل دلالة في النار. أعاذني الله وإياكم أيها المستمعون الكرام، وأسأل الله جل وعلا فوق هذه المنبر أن يوفقنا لما يحبه الله ويرضاه، وأن يجنبنا الفتن ما زهر منه وما بطن. أحبتي في الله، اسمعوا لي وتدبروا معي. ربنا جل وعلا أمرنا بذلك فقال: أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها. اليوم إن شاء الله خطبة سيكون حول الإسلام، معناه كما جاء في الحديث ابن عمر رضي الله عنه قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، معنى الحديث بني الإسلام، وفي رواية أركان الإسلام. بني الإسلام على خمس. الإسلام بني على خمس. أول شيء شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله. محمدا عبد الله ورسوله، يعني كلمة توحيد. والأخيرة أول شيء شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمدا عبده ورسوله، بعدين وإقام الصلاة، الصلاة وإيتاء الزكاة، والصوم رمضان، وحج البيت إن استطاع إليه السبيل. Brothers, we thanks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This hadith, inshallah, we're going to refresh our brain to repeat back this hadith, because everyone know this hadith. As long as you are Muslim, to accept for say you are Muslim, you have to say these words. You have to practice, to exercise what those mean. Otherwise, your name is a Muslim, but you're not a Muslim. Bun Umar, you know Abdullah Bun Umar. His father is Umar Farooq. Everybody know Umar. It's Khalifa Thani بعد Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. This Umar, he have a lot of son, but he once explained to us this hadith. His name Abdurrahman Abdullah bin Umar Ridwanullah alayhim. He said, Samitu Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul. Here Prophet Muhammad was saying, it was jama'ah among of many people. Prophet Muhammad was saying this hadith, but who told us? Abdullah bin Umar. He said, Prophet Muhammad was saying, Bunya al-Islam ala qams. As long as you're Muslim, you have to listen to this hadith. It says, to build of this religions, a build of on five pillars. Five pillars. First, shahada, kalma shahada. To say, معنى لا معبود بحق إلا الله هو التوحيد لا معبود بحق إلا الله no one except to worship beside Allah no gods except beside Allah they have so many gods but they are nothing God is one Allah فين ربي سماء God is in the sky يرى ما تفعلون ويسمع ما يقولون He saw whatever we doing God He hear what language you say English, Arabic any language you say God know what you say وبذلك قال ربنا جل وعلا وما يلفظه ما يرمى يرمى ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه لديه رقيب ملائكة يخبر يصف يكتب أتيد يعني يكتب It's anything you say from your mouth it be good or bad It's an angel ملائكة next to you watching you and write down what you say Any word you say, you have to, the angel next to you have to write down. So it's me, if you know now the angel going to write what you say, they're going to write what you did, you're doing. What? Brother, just say somebody have to move his car. Outside, please. Last numbers, six, I have it. Three. And a Sam Holland. There's a two yellow card by Bostomo. 6D24. 6403. 6403, please, move your car.
You come for prayer and at the same time, you're hitting some other people outside.
Shalom.
Like a 3 block away or 4 blocks, so you're gonna have a peace of mind when you come to pray. It's not good to stop imam, you know, at this kind of.
Inshallah.
It's not.
Inshallah, brothers. Let me continue the hadith. We say Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say, وَمَا يَلْفِظُ مِنْ قَوْلٍ إِلَّا لَذَيْهِ رَقِيب حَتِيب. Anything you say, It's an angel next to you, watching you, and write down what you say. And write down what you did. So it's mean, brothers, you have to be careful what you're saying or what you're doing. Especially we're akhir jaman, fitna, had kathra al fitna. So many fitna these days. You have to watch you what you say and what you do. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to us, كراما كاتبون يعلمون ما تفعلون. It's an angel, the duty to write down what he's saying, what he did. They know what he's saying. They hear what he's doing. They saw what he's doing. Brothers, Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is a shahadat Allah ilaha illallah كلمة توحيد. We have a big problem in when it comes to Tawheed. Those messengers from Adam, Nuh, to Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, everyone came for one reason, At-Tawheed. At-Tawheed, Uluhiyya, Warububiyya, Wa'asma' Sifat. They all came for one reason. After, you say, أشهد الله أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. To believe for say Prophet Muhammad is a slave from Allah. It's a messenger from Allah. It's a slave from Allah, it's a message from Allah. From that, he said, وإقام الصلاة. إقام الصلاة. After he says كلمة توحيد, now we have to perform صلاة. إقام الصلاة. إقام الصلاة. How? Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said the hadith, صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي. Pray the way you saw me praying, so do the same thing what I do. Do the same thing what I do. Same prayer I did it. Why Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that? Because Jibreel alayhi salam, he's a teacher of Prophet Muhammad. He came to Prophet Muhammad. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Jibreel angel to Prophet Muhammad. He came down to Prophet Muhammad and to pray in front of Prophet Muhammad, and Prophet Muhammad saw Jibreel the way he was praying. He saw him how Allah allowed him to perform the prayer. After Jibreel alayhi salam went, Prophet Muhammad is standing on top of the mimbar like this. Because Sahaba is so many people, he sat on top and exercise the prayer the way the Jibreel saw him how to pray. Prophet Muhammad, after he teach the Sahaba how Jibreel teach him, he said, this is Salah, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered us to do. This way you have to do. What time was that? Salat al-Duhur. That's first prayer. Prophet Muhammad makes Salah, Salat al-Duhur. Brothers, ask yourself now. As-Salah. Allah say, inna salata of ta'keed, inna salata tanha an al-fahsha wal-munkar. Is'alu nafsak. Is'alu nafsak, ya Abdullah, ya Aisha, ya Muhammad, ismu. Ay ismu mawgud hunak. Is'alu nafsak. Inna salata tanha an al-fahsha. Inna salata tanha an al-sharf wal-sarb al-qamr. وأكل أموال الناس بدون الحق. It's the salah. He said, pray, you pray. He have to stop you to doing bad. So do you pray stop you to backbiting people? Al-khiba, wal-namim? The salah, you make the salah. If that salah stop you doing a wrong, ask yourself, it's al-nafsal. اسأل نفسك يا عبد الله يا عائشة يا بنت ask yourself sisters and brothers if this prayer stop you cheating if that prayer stop you backbiting if this prayer stop you in haram stuff if this prayer stop you to drink beer alcohol if those prayers stop you to cheat with somebody's wife, somebody's daughters. If those prayers stop you to watch your mouth, if this prayer don't stop you to do those things, ask yourself, when you gonna stop now? Because Allah says, inna salata tanha anil fahsha wal munkar. You pray salat al-fajr, or ba'din khalas, fi sawara. After finish salah fajr, انت عيش انت في السوار في محلات دكان وخلوة مع المرعى شرب الخمر حشيش كل المحرمات. You outside from the masjid now, you anywhere you go now, you talk to women is not your wife, you drink, you smoke, you do any all kind of bad stuff. So ask yourself now if this salah stop you doing those wrong things. My brothers, if a salah do not stop you, have to cheat people. Ask yourself, do you do this salah right way or wrong way? If you do this salah right way, according to me, wallahi, this salah gonna stop you. If you want to do something wrong, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala going to come to your mind, your brain, right away, you will stay away from it.
But when you pray Allahu Akbar, Assalamu Alaikum, ما في الخضوع ولا الخصوع. الله أكبر والسلام عليكم. You keep doing like that, that's salam, not gonna stop in that room. Brother, ask yourself. So, the way you dress, Alhamdulillah, it can't be sunnah. That's what sunnah says, the way you have to dress. But the sunnah stop you from wrongdoing? The salah stop you from wrongdoing? As it says. From this hadith, as-salah was one of the best pillars of this arkan Islam. Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, inna awwal shay, يعني إذا مات ابن آدم, awwal shay fi al-khabr, if you pass away, the first things they're going to ask the day of judgment, as-salah. فإذا صلحت فقد أفلح وأنجى. If you do the salah right way accordingly, you easy pass. You're going to be okay. You're going to be escaped from Jahannam. You're going to be free from fire. Brothers, Prophet Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام يشمر أولادكم. الصلاة 7 سنين. Talk to your kid when they are 7 years old. To practice how to perform the salah. The father don't know, mom don't know how you're gonna process to tell your kid. Father, get up from the bed, go to work. He came back home 10 o'clock or 11 o'clock from Salat al-Dhuhr, Asr, Maghrib. He pray 5 minutes. He go watch basket, soccer, Olympic. How you got chance to talk to your kid? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, qu anfusakum, protect yourself. Wa ahliikum nara, wa qudhuha an-nas wal hijara, alayha mala'ikatun shidadun khilal, la ya'suna Allah ma amarahum, wa yaf'aluna ma yu'marun. Is'al nafsak, ask yourself, before you talk to your king, are you self, do you self do that? My brothers, Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, one day in this hadith, we say, Bunya al-Islam ala khams, or arkan al-Islam khams. This hadith, one day Sahaba Islam Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, Ridwanul Ali, قال سئل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أي أعمال أحبه إلى الله. Someone asked Prophet Muhammad from the Sahaba. He said to Prophet Muhammad, what deed is good? Or Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love it? Which one is Allah love most? Answer, listen to answer of Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam to the Sahaba. He said, As-salatu ala waqtiha. As-salatu ala waqtiha. To pray, perform the prayer on time. مثلا انا اضرب لكم مثال مثلا صلاه الفجر عندنا مسجد عباد الرحمن احنا صلينا الساعه 4:30 انت ما شاء الله نام يا كنوز موجود طول الليل اخذ عكس يويك اب بعد ال 12:30 1 o'clock that's the time because you got AC's on 4 times for to pray in Fajr. He prays Fajr at 1 o'clock. 4 times he's going to get up to pray. You pray in 11 o'clock, 10 o'clock. Ask yourself, if that salah going to stop you, do wrong? No. You have to perform the salah on time. He said, As-salah ala waqtiha. Ayyu a'malu ahabbuhu ila Allah. What did God love most? He said, to perform in prayer on time. Brothers, it's enough, sir. Ask yourself now. Do you pray on time? Do you pray on time? That's a big duty. From that hadith, alayhi salatu wasalam, Prophet Muhammad keep going. He said, وَإِتَاعِ الزَّكَاةِ وَإِتَاعِ الزَّكَاةِ الزَّكَاةِ الْمَفْرُوضَةِ. He said, give charity to miskin, people who need it, your charity. Muslims today, we give a sadaqah, but we don't know the charity. Most of us, we don't give a charity. We just give money, see miskin outside, give him $10, $5, $3. That's not charity, that's a sadaqah. That's called sadaqah. A charity from 2,500, according to the goal, 2,500, 2,700, sometimes 3,000, the goal, we got. From that, it takes 25%, I mean 2.5, it's made $25 out from the first 2,500 or 2,700. After 1 year, from the first one, 8,000 now, you take $225 out. If you have $1,000, it's not jackpot. You have $2,000, it's not jackpot. You can give sadaqa, but it's not a jackpot. You say, wait, that is zakah, to give you jackpot, sadaqa. To who? Who's going to accept the jackpot? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Surah At-Tawbah. إنما الصدقات للفقراء والمساكين وعاملين عليها ومعلف قلوب وفي الرخاب والخارمين وبين السبيل وفي سبيل الله وبين السبيل فريضة من الله. Those eight categories have to give you each sadaqa is meaning zakat today. Muslim, we don't, most of us, we don't give a zakat. After the hadith, the five pillars, sahada and prayer, and zakat, Prophet Muhammad go, he said, وحج البيت. حج البيت. And then hadith say, some Ramadan. He put the fasting before, he put Ramadan, I mean Hajj before. He said, وَسَوْمُ Ramadan, to fast Ramadan. Most of excuse comes when Ramadan comes. أقول قول قول هذا استغفر الله ولا قول استغفر الله.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد خاتم النبيين وإمام المرسلين. أحبت في الله، كما قلنا لكم الخطبة سيكون حول أركان الإسلام، وفي رواية بني الإسلام على خمس: شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله وأن محمداً عبده ورسوله، وإقام الصلاة، وإيتاء الزكاة، والصوم رمضان، وحج البيت إن استطاع إليه السبيل. This hadith today we're going to try to explain it, to translate to the English as the way we can have to do it. Well, we're not qualified for English. So this hadith, we say to give charity to people who need it. Allah already say the eight category who need this, who supported to accept those sadaqah. Now people like somebody healthy, you don't have to walk, you still want more, brother, give me sadaqah. Brother, you gotta go to work for you to give sadaqah to somebody. So, after this, ita is zakah, we say, as-sawm Ramadan, to fast Ramadan. Month of Ramadan, when month of Ramadan come, if you healthy, fast Ramadan. But when Ramadan come, most of the people bring excuse. My brother, my doctor, my stomach, my waist, too much complaining. Too much excuse when it comes to Ramadan. Only one thing I will say, brothers, إن الله يراكم ويسمع ما يقولون. Allah will know you more than you know yourself. You know yourself more than someone behind you.
accepting you to do or not do it. Allah says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, kutiba alaykum siyam, kama kutiba ala ladhina min qablikum, la'allakum tattaqun. That's the result. If you want to fast, it's a big reward in this fasting. Prophet Muhammad said, من صام رمضان إيمانا به واحتسابا غفر له ما تقدم من ذنبه. Brothers, if you want to have a reward, please, when Ramadan comes, you're okay, try to fast is better. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, وحز البيت, to go to Mecca. It's a big problem now these days for to go to Mecca for us. He said, إِنِ اسْتَطَعَ إِلَيْهِ السَّبِيلِ الْإِسْتِطَاعَ. It means not everyone going to Mecca. Somebody got money, is healthy, but some reason he can't go to Mecca. Somebody's healthy, he got money, but some reason he cannot go to Mecca. That's why he said, إِنِ اسْتَطَعَ إِلَيْهِ السَّبِيلِ الْإِسْتِطَاعَ. If he can. Example, I got money. I got paper. But I can't go. Why? I'm sick. That's another sentence. I just give you an example. Something like this, I can't go. You're sick, you cannot go, you're in the hospital. You can go. Allah will hello, let you know you're sick. That's what Allah said. فَمَنْ كَفَرَ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ خَلِيٌّ عَنِ الْعَالَمِينَ. It means whoever in istata' ilayhi sabil. If he can go, you don't want to go, Allah says, it's up to you. The benefit go to you. The punishment go back to you. Umar ibn Khattab said, كان مات يهودي أو نصارى. If you healthy, you okay, you have money to go, you don't want to go, it means you dead as like the way Yahudi dead, or dead as the way a non-Muslim dead. Somebody say, brothers, $8,000 is too much money. $10,000 is too much money. Oh, is $10,000 too much money? As long as you get it, if you got $10,000, it's not too much money. Brother, trying to go to Mecca. If you don't go Mecca, you act like Mecca is nothing. This kid behind me, you think he's gonna go Mecca, he's just gonna say, I never know my father go to Mecca. My father never say nothing about Mecca. Because father is 8,000, 10,000 is too much for him to go. He got green card, he got money in the bank, he's healthy, but the money is too expensive for him, too much for him to go to Mecca. He only got money to buy expensive car, $40,000 car, $30,000 car, to open business, $100,000, $300,000 business, stores. I mean, merchandise. But to go to Mecca, that's too much. It's unnecessary. Ask yourself. For you to buy a car, $20,000, $30,000, to go to Mecca, $8,000, that's too much for you. Because you want to drive the car to build house back in your country or buy house here. You don't want to go back, but you have your own house right here. You get house back home. So you don't want to go back. Because why? It's not important for you, that's why. As long as man is still in his sabil, you don't want to go, it's not important for you. That's the answer. مَنْ اسْتَطَعَ إِلَيْهِ السَّبِيلِ. If all this happy, you don't want to go, it means you don't want to spend, you don't believe Allah. My brothers, this life is very short. إِنَّمَا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا لَعِبٌ وَلَهْوٌ. This life, too short. One day, you're going to leave this dunya. You're going to leave your car behind. You're going to leave your wife behind you. You're going to leave your business behind. وبذلك الرسول عليه الصلاة والسلام he said, لا تزال قدم بن آدم
يوم الخيام حتى يسأل عن أربعة. He cannot take step feet the day of the judgment. They're going to ask him for four things. The most important for us this dunya, المال. من أين اكتسب هذا الفلوس؟ وفيما أنفق؟ اسأل نفسك. من أين؟ إيش؟ How you make the money and how do you spend? That's a big, big problem. How you make the money? How do you spend? Before that day, accept yourself. You have to watch yourself. You have to make sure to know how you make the money and how do you spend it. Because you're going to ask them. They're going to ask you. Allah will know how you make it. He knew how do you spend the money. اقرا كتابك يوم القيامة يوم لا ينفع مالكم ولا بنون إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم. إلا من أتى الله بقلب سليم يعني التوحيد. فلوس فإن أبا طالب تبت يدا أبي لهب وتب ما أخنى عنه ماله وما كسب سيصلى نارا ذات لهب وامرأته حمالة الحطب في جيدها حبل من مسد. Next to فرعون لعنة الله عليه. One day he said, أنا ربكم الأعلى. فأخذه الله نكال الآخرة والأولى. Look the day Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to destroy فرعون. Look how he destroyed فرعون. He destroyed his life. People still don't believe for say فرعون, he dead. Allah said, وَالَّذِي أَلُكْ وَالْمَنْ خَلْفَكَ آيَةً. I will take out people to see you, to show your life, to see you dead body. After he came out, they saw the dead body. They know for say the God we used to believe, he dead. Inshallah, brother, it's a time to pray. Please come forward. There's a lot of people standing behind. Please give a room to the brothers to pray inside. Please, I don't know what happened. I don't know what happened. Please. If so, if so, Allah will help you. If they say, if they say, move, Allah is going to give you more space in the day of Jannah. Please let your brothers pray. Don't let your brothers stand outside. Give room to them. Inshallah, that's the khutbah. Today, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to us, لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ عَسَنَةٌ يَعَنِي الْإِقْتِلَعُ بِهِ قَوْلُهُ وَفِعْلُهُ. He said, Prophet Muhammad is an example for us to copy what he say, what he do. Prophet Muhammad says, صلى الله عليه وسلم, من كان يؤمن بالله واليوم الآخر فليقل خيرا أو ليصمت. Whoever believes Allah in the day of judgment, say something nice or quiet. Please don't try to use bad words so much. I saw Muslims these days, they use a lot of bad words. F word. Especially the kid who you have in America here. Every time they open their mouth, they have to use bad word. Brother, you say the ayah every time Allah says, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nar. Wa khudhuha an-nas wal hidara. Alayha malaikatun qilalun shidad. La ya'suna Allah ma amarahum wa yaf'aluna ma yu'ar. You hear Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, kullukum ra'in wa kullukum mas'ul 'an ra'iyatihi. You saw your son depends all the way down. Your daughter having tight pants. You see, you saw when he cut his hair. Brothers, you just care about dunya to make your money. You don't tell them to perform to pray. You don't watch, they don't care. Sometimes take the kid to go to parking lot,
Sit down with your family one day, have a barbecue, it's not haram. Take your kid outside, sit down with them, or even in your living room, talk to them nicely. Sometimes bring stories. Story of Prophet Muhammad, story of Isa, story of Yusuf. You know, share a story sometime with the kid. Don't let them scare you too much. Try to come close to you. If you're not here today, they're going to be next. But if they're away from you, they're not going to understand nothing. You want, if we're not here, those kids have to become imam, ustad. If we don't teach them, we don't close to them, if we die, those places, this place needs to be a bar here, down there, when they have a party. Look now to the Alhamdulillah, what happened here? We pray here. Most of the place they buy, they used to be church, clubs, bars. Now, Alhamdulillah, we perform and pray in those places. We have a reward from them. So if we, the way we do, they keep them follow us. After we did, everything's going to be over. They're going back to what they, where we got it. Inshallah, we don't want that to happen. Inshallah, Allah may jal hadihi jama'na jama'na wa huma wa tafarruhuna min ba'ki tafarruha ma'asuma. Qum ila salatikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.